Today we will consider five bills. The first bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 1137 by Senator Liu. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law in relation to the observance of all religious holidays by institutions within the State University and the City University of New York, and specifically adds the Asian Lunar New Year within the definition of such holidays. It also mandates that SUNY and CUNY not penalize students for the observance of religious holidays and makes provisions to allow students to observe any such holidays without harm to their school standing. This bill passed the Senate in the 2019-2020 session and no action was taken in the Assembly. There are no memos in support or opposition, and there are no fiscal implications to this bill. If enacted, this act would take effect immediately.
Are there any questions?
Move the bill.
Second.
The bill has been moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Without recommendation?
Aye.
The bill is reported to the floor. What was the committee vote, Beth?
It was 10 ayes, 1 AWR by Senator Oberacker.
Who was the AWR?
Senator Oberacker.
Oh, okay. The second bill on the agenda is number 1352 by Senator Serrano. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law and the public health law to require that medical personnel who provide direct medical services to patients complete 2 hours of continuing education or training in cultural awareness and competence that encompasses minority healthcare issues as a requirement for the periodic registration. This bill passed the Senate in the 2019-2020 session, and no action was taken in the Assembly. There are no memos of support or opposition. There is no fiscal implication, and if enacted, this act would take effect immediately.
In the meantime, we've been joined by Senator Gonardis. Are there any questions?
Move the bill, Madam Chair.
Bill has been moved. Second. Senator was moved by Senator Liu, seconded by Senator Rivera. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Were there any AWR or opposition, Beth?
Aye.
Yes. Senator Oberacker and Fine. Senator Griffo.
Okay. Thank you. What is the vote then?
It's 11.
11 to 2, or 2 without recommendation.
Well, correct.
The bill will be reported to the floor. The third bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 1407 by Senator Parker. Jan will read.
This bill amends the education law in relation to the establishment of an interagency task force within the State University of New York to study health literacy and develop recommendations for improving citizens' ability to make informed health decisions. This bill also spells out in detail who will comprise the membership of the task force and charges it to make specific recommendations to the legislature on strategies to improve the health literacy of residents in this state. This bill passed the Senate in the 2019-2020 session and no action was taken in the Assembly. There are no memos in opposition or support, and the fiscal impact for this bill is limited to the cost of publishing its findings. If enacted, this bill would take effect on December 1, 2021.
Any questions on the bill?
Move the bill, Madam Chair.
Bill has been moved. Is it second?
Seconded.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Without recommendation. Beth, do you have any without recommendation?
No, it is unanimous. Aye.
Unanimous. Thank you. The fourth bill on the agenda is Senate Bill 1519 by Senator Bailey. Jan will read.
This bill authorizes licensed optometrists who meet certain requirements to be allowed to prescribe a limited number of oral medications for the treatment of ocular disease. There are memos of support, from the New York State Optometric Association and the SUNY College of Optometry, and memos of opposition from the Medical Society of the State of New York and the New York State Ophthalmological Society, and a conglomerate memo, a giant memo from various county medical societies and medical specialty groups. If enacted, there's no fiscal cost to the state, and if this would take effect 2 years after it becomes law.
Are there any questions on the bill? Senator Liu.
Madam Chair, not so much a question as a quick comment that I think this bill brings the optometrists into parity with what they are able to do in the vast multitude of other states. And more importantly, it allows our constituents to access these important services more readily, especially in parts of the state where ophthalmologists actually are in short supply. Thank you for moving this bill, and I support this.
Second, Madam Chair.
Senator Jackson, do you have a question?
I said I second.
Oh, you second.
I guess I moved it then.
I guess you moved it. I do want to add to what Senator Liu said before we take the vote. New York is the last state. Massachusetts was next to last, and they recently passed a similar bill. This is the bill that passed the assembly in July of last year, and I had no role at all in the negotiation on this bill. We made some changes in terms of a letter from the sponsors to the State Education Department, trying to guarantee additional oversight, such as random checks and a little more accountability. But this is exactly the same bill that was passed, and hopefully we will be able to service the rural constituents who desperately need service, particularly the rural upstate and Southern Tier, where they may, Western New York, Central New York, where they do not have, as Senator Liu said, as many ophthalmologists as they do in New York City. So I vote for it. Are there any, all those in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Without recommendation.
We have one without recommendation from Senator Cooney.
Okay. Then the bill will be reported to the floor. The last bill on the agenda is Senate 1520 by Senator Bailey. Jan will read.
This bill creates a temporary state commission on affordable college education to study the 10 SUNY community colleges that do not participate in the Educational Opportunity Program, EOP, and makes recommendations for legislative action based upon its findings. Currently, 20 out of the 30 community colleges in the SUNY system participate in the EOP program. There are no members of support or opposition, and there are no fiscal implications that are to be that are to be determined. If enacted, this act will take effect on the 90th day after it becomes law and shall expire 2 years after such effective date.
Madam Chair.
Is there a motion to move the bill?
Move the bill, Madam Chair.
Moved by Senator Jackson, seconded by Senator Liu. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Without recommendation. Beth, will you read the opposed or the without recommendation?
It is a unanimous vote of aye.
Perfect. That concludes the meeting. The bill will be reported to the floor, and that concludes today's meeting of the Senate Committee on Higher Education, and it is now 11:15.
Yapana.
Thank you.